just turned purple. 360 up front, it all comes full circle. Class photograph, Sandy had me on my Urkel.
Yeah. Mahomes about to fall short a couple hundred. Tube! What's up? Now, who's not salvageable? Kerryon Johnson. I like Kerryon Johnson. I think he's a phenomenal talent. I really think he can, you know, return to his form if he committed himself. I feel like his balance, him as a running back, he has balance, vision, and speed. I like that. Just give me that. I'll work with everything else. Balance, speed. Now, what got him benched was fumbles. What got him benched was lack of production. His lack of production last year. It remains to be seen that he is an elite back. He's not. We have a very special running back in our backfield with Swift. You can see night and day Swift's body as compared to this dude. And then we just signed a guy. He is on the fringe. Kerryon Johnson might not have a career. That's just facts. In 2 years, a year, he might not even be in the league. And I don't think he cares. My reasoning for this is, one, 2020 season, Hockenson spent his time working out, hosting workouts, getting in shape, came out ripped. You've seen the results of that. He, then again, in 2021, working with Cephas, getting right and get ripped. Kerryon Johnson, not one video, not one post, not one nothing. Now, I was hard on Okuda about posting this shit, right? And I'm like, oh yeah, you know, don't post shit. Hockenson was working out in February. He was working out in March. It was consistent. It was when nobody was thinking about Corona. He was working out during Corona. He was working out of the offseason, working with Stafford. And that's what I look for with players. With players who want to be leaders, things like that. I look for work ethic. I look for what can you do when you're not doing anything. You understand? And that's what really makes good players great players. And that's what really makes okay players very good players. Hines Ward's ability to study film, look at DB tactics, understand zones. He had this level of talent, but he worked his mind to be one of the all-time greats. You understand what I'm saying? From Kerryon, I don't see a willingness to compete. I just don't. And maybe I don't know him personally. I just feel like he's checked out mentally. I don't know if that's the, you know, that's the thing from last year, or that's the Patriot way, or whatever the fuck. Maybe he checked out of that mentally, but I've never really seen him. I mean, the dude don't even cut his hair. The dude don't care nothing about his appearance or whatever. He looks disheveled. Now, on a run, he can step in for Swift, and I think he can do well. You know, maybe if this was a different organization, he would have some type of pride in running the rock and, you know, just being a second option running back. But Kerryon Johnson was a second round, third round pick. And what he did at Auburn has yet to be shown here. He's had some flashes of immense greatness, and then he's had flashes of ineptitude. And I really think that his attitude will determine how far he goes. If he gets another contract with the Detroit Lions, if he remains on the team. Because his pass blocking is great. His this and that is great. But his work ethic, his training regimen, his mentality, it doesn't seem to fit with what the new regime wants. Almost like hardworking, misfit toy island motherfuckers. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you're gonna be just average or have an average mentality or start work at 9 and check out at 4:30 and, you know, no. Dan Campbell is not going to allow that. This new regime, this new air in the city is not going to allow you to exist.
So, Jelani Tavai, I believe, can be fixed, can be salvaged. Kerryon Johnson, you're on the fringe because your mentality. If he doesn't change his mentality, his work ethic, I mean, he was screaming at Liddy Mob. Come on, man. If he doesn't change his mentality and work ethic, he'll just be another guy. A dude occupying a jersey number, a uniform. My name is